Hey everybody, welcome back. It's another fishing video. Here we are in fishing North Atlantic, and today we're going to see how I do lobster fishing. I've been hearing a lot of other players in different communities complaining that lobster fishing in this game is broken or it isn't profitable enough, and I've kind of developed my own system that I feel works pretty good. So I'm gonna show you what I do. First of all, we're gonna be taking out the not guilty or not landing or what is it again? I remember this thing. It's the Knots Guilty, which I have renamed the Mud Bug because this is my lobster boat. And we are loaded up, I believe. Let me make sure we don't need any more. We currently have 200 of the lobster pots, so we are good there. But I believe we're going to need some bait. Yeah, I've got no bait, so we're going to buy a maximum of all 10 boxes. And we've got our crew already on board, so it is time to head out to sea. Now, I've got a little spot scouted out. First of all, if you haven't tried lobster fishing yet, I'm going to tell you, there's different boats that you can choose. There's the Arctic Pioneer is a really big boat, and that thing can hold like 120 crab pots, and it can dump out a string of 20 pots at a time and all that. But I prefer using this one, and you'll see why. It's mainly because I can be involved with the setting of the pots and all that stuff, because it's all right here close and readily accessible, whereas the Arctic Pioneer is such a big ship that there's a lot of walking back and forth, and it's time consuming. But with this boat, that's not an issue. Now, the only downside is it doesn't hold as much cargo space as the Arctic Pioneer, so your catch is going to be slightly smaller. But I personally don't think it's a bad trade-off. Now, if you haven't fished for lobster before, then go press the M key here to your map, go up here to the wiki, and go down to fish types, and you will see under lobster it says that they are best caught from April to July. So right now in the game, I don't believe it stops you from catching fish when they're out of season, but their numbers are usually down. They're not going to find them as easily, and usually you're not going to get a very good price for them. So if you're going to fish lobster, make sure it is between April and July. We are in the first week of April, about to enter the second week, so we are good there. Now, like I said, I have scouted out a spot. I was doing some long line fishing over here earlier, and I noticed on my sonar I was finding a lot of lobster on the sea floor, so I figured I might as well come on over here and give this a try. So let's head out to sea, shall we? Okay, so right away you're going to notice there's a buoy here that's one of mine, and it's because the game glitched on me and only gave me one buoy and not a second one, so I wasn't able to pick this one up, so I basically just have to wait until it's like been in the water for 2 days and then it'll disappear. So nothing I can do about that right now. But we are getting ready to set some lobster pots, so the way I go about this is I am going to choose a path, which right now is going to be going this way. And we are going to set our trawl speed here. 20 knots, I guess, is fine. And forward we go, and we're looking on the bottom here for some lobsters to appear. Now, I've got my depth here set at 100 meters, so every time we see a lobster pop up on here, it doesn't just mean one lobster, it means a group of lobsters. So if we see multiple lobsters pop up on the bottom, then we're finding very large groups of lobsters. So hopefully we'll see something here soon. boat. So as soon as that appears on the right-hand side of the screen, that means the boat is passing directly over it. So we know we've got at least one group of lobsters under us. So what I do, I'm going to kill that. There's another one that just popped up. Okay, so we're definitely coming into some lobster here. So we need to get our crew working. So I'm going to drink. Now, you've got choices here for how you set and bait pots. If you drop a guy over in here, I'm not really sure what the snowflake means just yet. I haven't, this type of boat, I've never really used this, but I'm pretty sure, like with the crab fishing, this is just setting one pot at a time. But I'm not doing that. I'm going to drag him over here because you can change this from either 5 or 10. I'm going to leave it at 10, and he's going to set a string of 10 pots here on the back deck. He's going to take them off the stack, put them down until you got 10 of them out here, and they're all strung together. Now, the cool thing about this is unlike on, well, the Arctic Pioneer, you can help, but like I said, you're walking from the bow to the stern back and forth with each pot, and it takes a lot longer, and I'm going to show you why it's better on this one. First, we're going to get out of the wheelhouse here and head to the back, and now if you're standing in the right spot, you can just do this. Grab a pot, set it down. Grab a pot, set it down. And just like that, there's 10 pots. Now, he just stopped because he's done, because the way the AI does it is it puts a pot down and then it baits it. And then it puts another pot down and then it baits it. Now, I haven't cut any bait for him yet. The AI doesn't cut bait themselves. You have to do that. So, we need to get some bait. Two boxes of bait will fill the bait box. So we get the hydraulic guillotine here and chop our bait all up. And as you can see, he's already started adding bait to those empty pots. And now I can help. And I can do it the same way that we did before with the pots. I can just grab them and throw them down. And as you can see down in the bottom left-hand corner, it says bait 6 pots. Bait 5 pots. Bait 4. And it's going to jump one because he's going to catch up to me. Now, they just skipped over 3. It says bait 2. And bait 1. Now we prepare the line, which he might do. There it is. The line is prepared. And he threw the buoy over the back. Now, he's already started setting down another string of pots. So, we go back to the wheelhouse, and we throttle the boat up, and you're going to see those pots get ripped right off the back. Away they go. And that's that. Now we watch the sonar again, and we wait to find some more lobster. There we go. There's another group. So, bring her to a halt. And we stop the boat. And we're going to do this a couple more times. And then, boom, again, we've got more lobster. Now we got a lot of lobsters showing up. Look at that. There's 4 of them that just came up on the same screen. There's a lot of lobster here. Okay, so we're going to do something different. I'm going to stop my guy from working here because this is the trick that I've figured out. So since we're dropping the bait, we got 10. All right, try to figure out a way to explain this so it's easy for you to understand. A little bit of math involved here. One box of bait will do 20 pots. So since we're putting 2 boxes of bait into the bin here, then that means we can do 40 pots. Now there's 10 pots in a string. We've done 1, 2, 3, 4 strings. Okay, so if you're gonna try to do this like I am, once your bait bin is out, you've done 4 strings. So stop, Don't set anything else. And now go into your brew house here and advance the time by 4 hours. Okay, so now these pots have all soaked for 4 hours, and now we can continue. So we're gonna get our guy back out here on deck. And we're going to continue just like we were before. That's the only thing you're gonna do different. You're setting 10 pots, setting and baiting 10 pots at a time. That's it. It's just every fourth string, stop and advance the time ahead by 4 hours. You'll find that when it comes time to pull and sort all of these pots, once you haul in all this lobster and start setting them, that 4 hour time difference between groups of four strings is going to help you, because it takes a long time to sort this lobster. And if you were to just drop all of these strings all at once, you'd only get through about half of them before the later group starts to go bad. Like they'll have been soaking for like 24, 25, 26 hours before you can get to them. And at that point, the lobsters start dying. So by putting a 4 hour break in between groups of four strings, you're allowing yourself that time so that all of the pots are going to be good by the time you get to them. So we're just going to continue on and bait these up. And I will see you again when it is time. Once we have all these pots, we're going to set every single one of these. And then we'll pick it up once we've got all these in the water. Okay. So there we go. Our final pots are in the water. 200. All the bait is gone. And now we're just going to head back to the beginning where we started this. And about 3 hours left to go. Well, let's go 4 hours. We'll advance it 4 hours. That would be a nice even round number. And then these first four strings will be ready to pick up. Okay, so this is how we do that. We're gonna go again, 4 hours. And where are we at? There's our first group of pots up there. So let's get our boys on deck here. I like to use this guy that I did all my pot setting with. He's the best I have at sorting. I mean, that's a lot better than any of the other ones that I've got here. He's pretty low. He's halfway. And Rudy here, he sucks. So we've got Mikhail here. He's, I guess you could call that Michael. That's a weird spelling, but we'll have him do the sorting, and Graham here is going to do the pot hauling. And then I'm going to show you the other good thing about using this boat, that you can also help sort on the Arctic Pioneer as well. It's just a little more awkward. We're gonna pull up to this first pot. There we go. He grabbed it. And as they bring it aboard, I'm gonna hop out of the captain's seat here. Heave! And not looking bad. There's a few lobsters in there. That's a keeper. So what you're looking for is they gotta be 3 inches between the eyes and tail. So that bottom part of this measuring device has got to come to the base of the thorax. If it overlaps to the tail, they're too small. So this is a keeper. So we're going to put rubber bands on his claws, and into the box he goes. There's another big one. Look at the size of that monster. Into the bin. That one's right on the edge, but I'm gonna keep him. And this is how you do it. Now, if you choose to, okay, so this guy we're gonna throw away. So this is how you throw him away. Just aim him back at the ocean and press the E button. E for yeet. There's a big old monster. These are lobstosauruses. Nope. Nope. There's a good one. All right, so this is basically all there is to it, guys. Now it is just a game of time. In case you're wondering, all 200 of those pots, it took me about 20 minutes to bait and set all of the pots that I had. 20 minutes. And it is now, let's see, just for my own personal reference, I'm gonna say right now, it is 10:15 a.m. as I'm recording this. So we'll see what time it is when I'm finishing up the last few pots. So I'm going to, right now is the hard part for me, but it's the easy part for you, because the next time you see me, I'm gonna be finishing, but I got a lot of work to do until then. So we'll be right back through the magic of editing. All right, you guys, we're just finishing up the final pot of the fourth string. All right. So let's see where we're at. And we are at 9,000 pounds of lobster. We had one that was under 500 pounds. I think it was the third string, was only around 300 pounds or so, and we had a lot of lobster, but they were small. They were a lot of throwbacks. These things were like, they were practically crayfish, they were so small. But right after finishing four strings and having almost 10,000 pounds, I'm feeling good about this. I think if we can keep these numbers on these averages, then we should definitely stuff this boat and fill it up to all 44,000 pounds. So, and as you can see, the next two strings and the next group of four have already turned blue. So, like I was saying, giving yourself that 4-hour time cushion in between groups of four makes it so, if we had not done that, if we had just dumped out like eight groups of pots, all one right after another, then these two pots right here that are currently at 18 hours, they would be at 22 hours already, which is past when they're best. And by the time you get all the way here to these pots, they would have been like a day and a half old by the time we got to them. So that's why I do a group of four and then take a 4-hour break. Do a group of four, take a 4-hour break. It spaces everything out so you have time to count your lobster after each catch before you move on to the next one, and your next groups won't spoil by then. Okay? So the next time I see you, we should be finishing this up. Okay, you guys, this is the last pot. This is number 200, and wow, look at that monster right there. That's a good one. Unfortunately, back he goes, because as you can see, our boat is full. We ended up hitting the max storage on like the 17th string, so the last 30 pots we just kind of dumped them over the side. So yeah, 200 pots, took 170 of them to fill the boat, and just in time too, because for some reason the sea has apparently turned into a jello mold I don't know what is going on with the physics there, but we are done. The boat is full. Now it is just to see where we can get the best price. So we're going to go to the finance tab, fish prices, and let's see, lobster in Yarmouth is $14.21 a pound, $14.31, $29.31, $31.27. So it looks like we've kind of got our pick here between Lunenburg, Ingalls Head, and Digby. So let's see who's closest. Where are we at? Lunenburg. Looks like I'm going to say we're closest to Lunenburg, I guess. That is 4 hours, 56 minutes, 7 hours, 5 hours. So yeah, we're closest to Lunenburg. So we don't have to do any cleaning or anything like that. So we can actually just fast travel up here to Lunenburg. And hopefully sell a whole mess of lobster. I'm going to say probably 44,000, 14 bucks a pound, 800,000, I think. Let's see. Oh, wow, I was off. That's right, I was thinking when I sold it $11 a pound, that's where I miscalculated. But yeah, 1.2 million. So for those that say it's not profitable, yeah, 1.2 million. but anyway, however, there is an asterisk with that 1.2 million, because if you want that 1.2 million, you have to put in the work. Remember when I said before, when we finished setting the pots and we were gonna start pulling them, and the time I said was 10:15 a.m. So we were gonna start at 10:15 and see how long it took me to finish. Well, it is now 12:20. So it took me 2 hours and 5 minutes to do everything that you didn't see me do because I've edited it out. So grand total, almost 2.5 hours from beginning to end on setting the pots and catching all of these lobster. So if you have 3 hours to kill and you like repetitive tasks, lobster fishing is a great way to do it. However, if all you're looking to do is try to earn as much money as you possibly can, as fast as you can, then you're probably gonna wanna stick to either trawling or long lining. But this is how to do it with a lobster boat. And if you're up to the task, it can be a lot of fun. I enjoy it. So I hope this helped. I hope this answered any questions you may have. If you have more, leave them down in the comments below, and I will try to get to them as soon as I can. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.